Welcome back, everyone. I'm the Depressed Eeyore, and this is Brigandine. As you can see here, I have all my three party members selected, and we're gonna attack this place. Thing we've gotta kinda worry about in this fight is the fact that they have two decent level knights. The Berserker here is pretty strong, and he also has Road Bull, which is a bishop. Besides that, everything else we should be able to handle. The rock can be a little annoying if it gets petrifications off, and the demon can do some damage if she gets off some spells. The demon's pretty much the opposite of an angel. Has attack spells, has a venom spell that can cause poison, and a curse spell, which is pretty much divine ray, except a dark version of it. So, we're gonna attack. So, yep, everyone's attacking. Let's do this. Execute. Yeah, you're gonna take over my city? I'm gonna take over yours first. I could fail, though. Yeah, I have some low-level characters at the moment. Something to note, every faction has their own music for combat and on the map. I definitely like Leonia's combat music a lot more than the other ones. Anyway. Bam, bam, bam. Depending on where that knight is attacking from, decides where their starting position is. So you can actually attack from multiple fronts if you really care to. Yeah, since this is on hard mode, they're just gonna wait. No big deal. Alright, this map is... we're gonna be going across a river here. A very wide river here. Or a lake, or whatever. And so we're gonna have some issues. We have to go across bridges. Some units can go... a lot of my units can fly, so it's not that big of a deal. A lot of units won't be able to go into water at all. Oops, wrong button. That sucks. I accidentally made my wyvern wait when I didn't want it to. But whatever. It's gonna take me a little bit to get everyone in a position, so... no rush. This is an upgraded form of a unicorn. It's Pegasus. It can fly. It knows three heal spells. So instead of heal and halo, it also knows cure, which will be useful for removing any petrification we happen to suffer. We're gonna go ahead and focus our attacks down this way. I might see about taking advantage of the bridges here and going from there. Okay, let's go ahead and move you. A bunch of flying units. Something to note, the Hydra here, which is a water element creature, is a water type, which means they move very slow on land, but they move a lot faster on water, and they also get a bonus while they're in water, if they happen to be fighting in it. So that thing could be an issue. Okay, turn two. That little city that he's standing in, any unit that happens to be standing there when a new turn begins will recover 100 HP. So it's a very good spot to put, like, wounded units. Okay, move on up. There we go. Remember the movie this time. Now, despite the fact that the AI is smart enough to at least wait for me to come, you can actually bait them pretty easily. I'm not sure if I'll do that, but, because it is kind of cheap to do it sometimes. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll position myself to blitz them as quickly as possible. Right now, the important thing to do is to get people towards that bridge. As you notice, this is a hex-based game, which is awesome, because hex-based is the best. Okay. Yeah, they're just gonna wait for me. They'll wait until either I hit them, or I get too close. Which can vary. Usually it's based off the range of whatever unit you're moving forward. Let's see. Okay, we'll be alright. We'll go here. There. going to go ahead and cast Protect on my Griffin. This will up its defense for a few turns. Or maybe it's based off hits, I don't remember. So we're going to kind of put ourselves a little wall here. That'll keep them defended. Cloth, you're just going to have to stay out of the way for the moment. I mean, all Cloth has right now is just defenders, support units anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. And he only has two monsters. So we'll go ahead and move you, get you buffed up. Perfect. And what we want to do is go ahead and start moving you up. Actually, I probably will bait them towards the bridge so I can funnel them. Do I want to move here? Yeah, why not? If it gets... I'm making sure. Yeah, I'll be alright. The turn order is decided by the level of the knight. So the AI goes first, simply because he has higher level knights than me at the moment. Yep, they're active now. Solid Claw. Yep, this is what you'll get if you have the battle animations up. Hit. 127 damage. Thankfully it didn't petrify me. Counterattack. Tail whip. There we go. Yeah, they're ganging up on my wyvern. That's okay. Missed. This is why I don't like using giants. But it's free damage for me. Your guy. Oh, okay, you're not gonna attack with him. That's fine. Let's see, magic wise, I don't have right now she doesn't have too much mana, so seeing what threats there are. I really want to get rid of that rock, so let's go ahead and cast Frost on this fellow here. Not too much damage, but it's alright. She's pretty low level. Alright, let's attack with Tail Whip. Okay, no petrify yet. Oh, and I leveled up. When you level up, monsters just get stats and HP and MP. Knights will get things like Rune Power as well. Yeah, if we take out the rock, we'll be in pretty good shape. Yep, there it is, petrified. Not a big deal. I at least have characters that can remove it. If you don't have anyone that can remove petrify, you're in trouble. Alright, we're just gonna have to have you wait, because you're out of range. Wait, no, I can cast cure, never mind. Problem solved. If you are petrified, your defense does go up, but you're practically helpless. Pretty much, you just want to keep spamming your protect spells with your pixie so they can level up. you up a step. That's pretty much all she can do. This thing's practically dead. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and use my Holy Griff here. I'm gonna go ahead and do Feather Storm, which is a ranged attack. Monsters that die are gone permanently. There's no way to really bring them back besides one spell, which is not only a temporary bring back. It doesn't actually bring them back forever. So there you go, got that going. Just seeing where I can move. Let's go ahead and move you up to here. How's everyone looking? Okay, you guys are alright. Let's move you up. I can attack the Berserker if I really want to. I'm probably not gonna do that at the moment. And we're gonna keep you where you are. Actually, I can heal everybody. Awesome, this is awesome positioning. I wasn't expecting to do this. So let's go ahead and do heal voice. I usually never use this move because it heals the enemy as well, but since there's no enemies around me, I get everyone to heal. It does use up MP to use this move, but it's not like I have anything else to use my MP for. So there you go, free heal. Alright, Kalaf is kind of gonna just be useless. You know, heal and Halo. Let's go ahead and move you up to there. And we'll go ahead and move you to there. Yep, now these guys are gonna start moving in. We've already taken out one of the monsters, so we're practically even at the moment, though I do tend to have a little bit more support monsters than they do. So that's okay. I mean, my Phoenix and Holy Griff should be able to take on most of these things, as long as I'm careful. Freezing Spiral. Hydras are pretty durable, it's just they're very slow is the big issue. They also have a breath attack. Critical hits, yeah. It hurts. But they are water elemental, and I do have a phoenix, so I'm gonna rip him a new one with my phoenix. I'm a little nervous about that demon, though. Oh no, attacking my pixie! Leave my pixie alone! I'm gonna lose a pixie at this rate. Ow. And no crit. Yeah, 25 damage. Not too special. Ghouls are they're pretty weak. They're just a very basic dark element monster. But they're very cheap, so you can kind of keep them around. They do upgrade to vampires, which aren't too special. But if you get them to Vampire Lord, you're in a good place, but that's very difficult to pull off, because ghouls are not very durable. They also have very poor hit rates, as you probably just saw. They do level up very quickly, though. Ouch, this is gonna hurt. Dark element versus white element. Sorry if there's a little bit of slowdown in these little videos. So far, it's not too bad. Power Fist. Maybe it'll hit this time. It will hurt if it does hit. Nope. It could be the fact that they're attacking into water, and the penalties do apply. I think it lowers like hit rate by like 15% or something like that. So I'm in a pretty good position. now we got all these people near us. Let's go ahead and, well, first things first, let's soften up some guys. Unfortunately, this will pretty much make her useless for the rest of the combat, because she doesn't have very much mana. That's a disadvantage of using low-level characters, but they do level up, so we got that going. Okay, that's dead. Taking out dark element units like him. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and attack with you. I want to take out this Hydra. Critical attack. Ow. Critical hit, 204 damage. Get a level up. Awesome. Alright. Can I reach him? Yes, I can. Holy Ward's a little bit weaker for an AoE spell, but it goes out 4 hexes, which includes this hex right here that has him. So, we're gonna go ahead and cast Holy Ward. It's gonna eat up a lot of our MP, but that's okay. Because this is gonna take out a knight. I don't believe this. Did I lose? Damn right you did. Yay, level up. Gives you rune power, more HP and MP. All the good stuff. She leveled up twice. If you take out a knight, there's a chance that they'll leave behind some of their monsters they had under control. And if they stay alive at the end of the battle, you get them for free. Be very useful sometimes, but it's not something you want to rely on. Since they lost a knight, they just decided to cut their losses and just retreat. So we killed two of their monsters and took out a knight. When you win a battle, you always get everyone gets 200 HP, so everyone gets a few level ups. Oh, Philo leveled. That's good. Alright, some quest. Isfa's quest. Isfa met a traveling merchant in the course of the voyage. They were able to get along through conversation and decided to travel together part of the way. Merchant, it's sad to leave you, but we have to part here. I'll give this to you. The merchant handed the Apostle's Horn to Isfa. I had just acquired it, but I like you, and you might need it. Well then, take care. Isfa parted from the merchant after exchanging a handshake. The Apostle's Horn. Yep, this is just that was just a free item quest. Legoborg's quest. While being lost in the forest, Legoborg came upon a strange fountain. Due to exhaustion, Legoborg decided to drink out of the fountain. The cold water quenched Legoborg's thirst. Ugh. All of a sudden, severe pain struck Legoborg's body. Legoborg fell onto the ground and blacked out. How long have I been out? Legoborg wondered. Legobard's body felt like it's been revived. The magic fountain should have taken out Legobard's potential power. Gained 4 agility points. So that was a stat-up quest. No, nothing special. It can be useful for some guys, but a lot of times it's not really worth the trouble. You're better off just leveling up a character if you really want to buff him up. Hey, Kalof. I haven't seen you in a while. Hey, Galen. What are you doing here? Look who decided to come along. Hi, Kalof. Aline, what are you guys doing here? Can't you say anything better than what are you guys doing here? Oh, I'm sorry. It's really nice to see you guys. It's nice to see you too. In case you were wondering, we didn't come here for vacation. And we didn't come here to see your face either. Isn't that right, Bailey? What? Yeah, you're right. Then why are you here? Well, we're here because... Come on, what is it? Bailey, why don't you tell him? Me? Come on, guys. Why are you guys acting like idiots? Idiots? Never mind. I don't want to tell you anymore. Fine, don't tell me. Ha ha. I'll tell you. We came here to support Leonia. What did you say? That's right, we're Runeites, like you. Is it true, Bailey? Yes, is it wrong? No, no, not at all. Came all the way here to support you guys. You should be more thrilled. Of course I'm thrilled. I'm sure Leonis will be happy too. Leonis. Are you still calling her Leonis? Uh-huh. What's wrong with that? She is the queen of the country, you know. So, I can call her whatever I want. Well, I guess anyway. Escort us to the queen. Okay, Leonis will be surprised to see you too. Galen joined, Bailey joined. So yeah, story-wise, you'll get some free characters, like these two. So we got ourselves a free archer, or scout actually. She's level 1, but she starts out with decent rune power for a level 1 character, so if you level her up, she's pretty good. In fact, that's who I intend on using. She has a ranged attack. So, congratulations, you get yourself a free unicorn and pixie. And you guys can go wherever. We also took over a new city, which means we probably have access to some new summons. Hydras, hellhounds, and mermans. Eh. Nothing too special. Oh well, let's move out, kill off Isfus. Kalanwan, and Legaborg. Actually, why am I moving them? Just get out of my sight. Go on a quest. Then for over here, let's go ahead and do some ordering. Here you can have that, that. Now that's certainly a start. Excuse me. Let's see, that'll give me... Okay, it's workable. It's not the best setup, but it'll work for now. So, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is delete these guys. We don't need them anymore. I'm gonna go ahead and move Asmet back to the capital, just so I can pick up more stuff. But we're at least in better shape now. Oh, I should have not deleted all those guys. Oh well. What can I summon here? I can summon a rock. Sure, let's summon a rock. Since we took over our city, we have more upkeep now. Or not upkeep, but more income, which is great. Which it also means that the Norgard Empire has less upkeep now. So their one advantage of having an extra city over everyone else, or two cities, is now reduced. Okay, let's organize. Sorry if I'm going a little slow. I always feel like I'm going too slow. Oops. I'm gonna go ahead and keep the scorpions as fodder. It's always good to have fodder. There we go. Oh, you're just 1 point short of being able to actually use this. Oh well. But now we have a decent setup here. I'm already moving you. Let's organize you. Okay, that's 85. How much room do you still have? 85, that brings it up to... 170. So if I have any 15 cost units, I could try to summon them, but I don't think I have any. No, I don't. Okay, so I don't need to worry about you. Let's go ahead and just move you over then. Does this city have any spare units? No. Okay. We're gonna be kind of open at the moment, because we don't really... We're probably gonna get a counterattack, simply because I don't have very many units here. But, this was our first victory, so let's go ahead and take that for what it is, and save our game. We have 7 domains instead of 6. What we'll probably end up having to do is we're gonna have to move another 3 knights up here with units, so I can attack and defend at the same time. It's gonna be a little bit difficult to spread across here, but once we get started, like once we take out this capital here, we should be able to expand a little bit easier. should be good to go. Let's go ahead and execute this build. So we got 13 monsters here now. We still have only 10 here. And one of them we can't even use because it's not even transferred. What do we got over here? Nothing too bad. Meanwhile, this guy's kind of he's now forced to split his units a little bit. And here's the leader, Vaynar the Lord. He might be an issue. Oh well, let's go ahead and execute our move. We're not going to attack this turn. Alright, Iskar's this task, listen noise. And he lost it. Oh, they're in trouble now. New Alamekia has attacked Norgard. Oh, they failed. But even if they fail, that means they're probably reduced units. Alright, Raisin's Quest. Okay, it's just the same stuff. This is a Gygus. There's Quest. There's our life. Turn around, there's a Gygus. I'm pretty sure we're not gonna get this. We're not gonna get a Gygus for free. Yep, there it goes, it escaped. It would've been awesome if we got a Gygus, that would've been just awesome. Alright. Legaborg found a beautiful waterfall located between the mountains. As the mist of the waterfall flowed into the air, a rainbow appeared. As Legaborg started to drink from the waterfall, a figure appeared from the waterfall. It was a water fairy. The water fairy started to sing as soon as she noticed Legaborg. Her song confused Legaborg. Strangely enough, Legaborg's body started to heal. After smiling at Legaborg, she returned to the waterfall. Gained that at max HP. Okay, Ryzen returns, and Legaborg returns. Out of all the knights, Legaborg is the worst knight. He's level 10 and only has 138 rune power. He also knows some sort of special strategy called... He calls himself the Brain... That's weird. I thought he knew something else. Something like called the Lightning. Whatever. He calls himself the Brain, originally from Norgard, but he left from when Vaynar took over the throne. He didn't think Vaynar had the ability to make a good king. He always bothers Queen Leonis with suggestions that have no meaning. Because he's a useless, useless guy. Actually, let's go ahead and... Since he's here. And me pressing the wrong buttons again. This is a monk, he has Rivet Knuckle. A unique thing about monks is they're melee units that know healing spells, but they also have the ability to a very, very small chance to cause paralysis. Also, their critical attack tends to happen more often as their hit points get lower. A man obsessed with fighting, he never talks to the other knights, but is always in search of someone to fight. He accidentally killed a man during Kumite, and is now despised by his people. However, he never made any excuses for the action. So there you go. Actually, since I'm here, let's go ahead and move the U over. And there we go. Pretty much a full house. If we happen to get, like, a ghoul, I can fit some more space. But it's generally a good idea to have a little bit of leeway, so you can upgrade units, because as you upgrade units, their cost will increase. Since I'm here, let's go ahead and take a look at Chantel. A magician of Leonia who can deal with anything with composure. He loves his baby very much and talks about him all the time, even in front of the queen. His dream is to make his son the palace magician of Leonia. He's not too bad. I just have no interest in using a mage right now. Actually, he'd probably be better, simply because, what's his name? In Norgard is actually blue element, so fire spells will do more damage to him, but whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and just quest for right now. Get up some funds. Let's go ahead and summon some more angels. Summon one angel. Oh yeah, I completely forgot. Fossil's Horn increases the rune area by 1. So, you got 4 rune area. What's your rune area? 3. Okay, we're gonna give it to her, so now her rune area is 4. I guess I haven't really explained what the rune area is. You probably saw in the combat that whenever I was moving units, there was like a blue little aura. If you have your, you need to keep your monsters in that blue aura. If you don't, their stats will drop drastically. Like all their stats, like their ability to hit, the amount of damage they deal will be reduced, and they'll take a lot more damage. So it's not a good idea to keep. It's a good idea to keep them in the blue area. If you don't, you're just asking for hurt. Sometimes I'll send them out of the blue area just for like a kill shot, but other than that, I wouldn't do it. But yeah, the Apostle's Horn is pretty good for characters that have very little rune areas, like the Archer. Because hers is only like 3 hexes, and now it's 4. Alright, let's go ahead and organize you. 85, that's... that leaves us with... 129. 35, 35. So we can get a few, centaurs. Yeah, let's get some centaurs. Centaur, I really didn't like centaurs when I first played this game. When I played as a Caerleon, their starting upgraded unit was a high centaur. And it missed all the time, like it never hit. And then I realized regular centaurs were even worse. But if you're very patient with them, they can definitely snipe units, and that's always good. So let's go ahead and send you off to there. Okay, and I don't think I have anything else to move, do I? Nope. Okay, execute. Let's go ahead and just execute our attack. Norgard's counterattacking. They succeeded. Nomikia is now attacking Escaras, and they succeeded. The Escaras Empire should actually, quite frankly, with what they start out with, they should stomp everyone, but they don't. And that was a 2-1-2, and Nomikia succeeded. Getting a weird little sound. I'm sure you guys are hearing it too. There you go, Scalia has also attacked. Galenwald's quest. While on a jury, Galenwald came across a theater. There seems to be trouble since there's a lot of noise coming from inside. Girl's voice. What? Are you telling me I'm fired? Man's voice. No, Katrina, that's not what I'm saying. It's just that since you're one of the Rune Knights, it's disrespectful for me to put you on the stage. Knight? Is that girl a knight? I'm a dancer, not a knight. Look at me, see? I can do the turns and raise my legs high. You're making a big mistake. You wouldn't want to see a good dancer like me leave. Please, let me get on the stage. Dancing is my life. My life. Please. You can cry all you want, but I still can't let you get on the stage. The audience wouldn't feel comfortable watching a Rune Knight dance on stage. I'm sorry, but I can't let you stay. Now get out! Ouch. What are you doing, you pervert? Nobody wants to work in a crappy theater like this anyway. You'll see. Someday I'll become a big star and you'll be begging me to dance here. Remember that. Are you alright? Galenwald gave her a handkerchief to wipe her tears with. Oh, thank you. I'm just pretending. Pretending? Uh-huh. Did I fool you too? A dancer must be able to act as well, you know. You must be have overheard the conversation. I don't know why, but I've got this mana power or something, and I never told anyone about it because I didn't care. I would rather be dancing than fight in a battle. When I finally mentioned it, everybody was shocked, and people started to treat me differently. They even call me Miss Cortina now, though I'm still the same person inside. Well now, I don't have a place to stay for the night. Miss Cortina, why don't you come to my country and work as a knight? What? Are you a knight? You sure are dressed like one. Galenwald talks Cortina into using her ability as a knight to restore peace in Forsina. The thing about rune power is it's kind of like a thing that you just happen to be born with, and it allows you to tap into, you know, the power of the runes, summon monsters, and all that fun stuff. As far as this setting is concerned, if you have the ability, the mana power or the rune power, you are pretty much automatically considered a noble. You're treated like a noble. So it's why there's this issue with Cortina wanting to be a dancer, because they're like, oh, you're a noble now. What? This is too sudden. A knight? I don't know. But I know there is less work for a dancer like me during a war. I don't have any particular place to go. Okay, I'll do it. The sooner we have peace back, the sooner I can start dancing again. If I think about it, the dancer who's safe for seeing it isn't that bad of a catchphrase for my future. But please, promise me when the war is over that you'll let me go back to being a dancer again. Of course, I will do all I can as a knight, but that's not what I want to be for the rest of my life. My goal is to become the number one dancer in Forsina. And there you go, we got ourselves another knight. Legoborg's quest. Legoborg is standing in front of a strange cave. Even with a torch, it is too dark to see in the cave. Legoborg steps in the cave carefully. Inside it was deeper than expected, and there are marks that reveal that someone has been here. Suddenly, something wriggling in the darkness of the path came into sight. Legoborg looked on. It was a giant. It looked like it strayed from its master. The giant is looking at Legoborg with a sad look. The giant looked so pitiful that Legoborg chose to take it home. And we got ourselves a free giant. I'm probably just going to delete it. Because it's so pitiful. Anyway, new characters. Okay, so we got ourselves another character. Our level 1 enchantress. Since she's just an enchantress, so she only has her 4 spells. She doesn't have the heal spell or anything like that. Apprentice dancer dreams of becoming the top dancer of a troupe that travels across the country. She is friendly and partial since she was raised in an open and free environment. When she feels good, she likes to dance for everyone. So, wait a minute. She's level 1, has more rune power and more MP than a level 8. So let's fix that. I mean, Philo is pretty good, but this character's better. And since she'll level up a little bit faster, she'll get more mana and more rune power. So there we go. Now we can still use this character for upgrades and stuff like that. Or not upgrades, but for defending. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is send you off to here. Anyone else I want to move? Man, we got Asmat. He's just going to hang around. So we need one other character. I think he'll probably be Kill-Off, but I'm not entirely sure. Oh yeah, is my... Okay, the giant's here, so let's get rid of him. Because we don't need you. And what can I summon here? Merman. Oh, I suppose we can just summon a scorpion since we have the room. Let's go ahead and do that. The merman and hydra could be useful on that particular city if you're attacked from the south, but since the only thing that's to the south is my city, they're not going to be that useful. Some hellhounds. Hellhounds have the ability to do a breath attack, and they also have the ability to do a hit and run. Oh, never mind, I can't afford you. What a waste. Here, you can have it. Oh, it's 20 cost, not 15. I thought it was 15. Let's just delete it. Not a big deal. Wasted 100 mana, but it's not a big deal. Alright, next thing. Just send people on quest. The AI does not send their units on quest, which is a disadvantage for them. Because they don't get access to a lot of units. There are some hidden... I guess background events that you won't really notice until it happens. Well, you won't know it happens until you notice that the AI has new units. But there are a few hidden things that will trigger for the AI that they'll give them some benefits, but not too many. So let's just go ahead and execute this move. So there you go. We got 4 knights here now. If I really cared to use any of them. Invading, and they succeeded. And, well, wow, they're just piercing right in. Norgard's in trouble. I mean, what's the bad part about having reduced cities is means that he has to having to pay, still pay upkeep for all those units, and he doesn't really have any mana to spare for new units. Kloth's quest. Kloth met a flower girl on the street. Flower girl, would you like a flower? You don't have to pay for them. Kloth responded to her kindness. Kloth reached out for a yellow sunflower. Flower girl, the sunflower, I like that too. It makes me cheerful when I'm having a bad day. Girl smiled. Kloth held out a small amount of money to her. No, you don't have to. It was free. Goodbye. The girl then disappeared into the crowd. Kloth smelled the flower and felt the power coming out of it. Gained 2 agility. Isfoss quest. Alright, so while walking along the road, Isfoss came upon a small bottle containing some liquid. The sign of the bottle said, "Free drink." Isfoss took the bottle and opened it, drinking the liquid without any hesitation. Isfoss noticed an unearthly aroma coming from it. After a while, Isfoss suddenly fell over. Sure enough, the liquid was some kind of poison, and Isfoss started to black out. Isfoss woke up in a strange room. Someone had brought Isfoss here. Isfoss had rested there for a month. Okay, so he's injured now. Chantel's quest. Same thing. Free drink. Drinks it. Fall over. Yep, and it's another poison. Okay. So now I have 2 wounded characters. Legboard's quest. Legboard was standing in front of a tall tower. Legboard went up to its doors, then opened them. It was dark inside as Legboard stepped in the door, and the door closed by itself. Legboard was determined to search about the tower. This webless tower seemed to have been abandoned by its owner long ago. Legboard made it to the top of the tower, top floor of the tower. There was a desk in the room with a thick book on top of it. Legboard picked up the book. The book was in bad condition, and the pages were easily crumbled. Legboard skimmed through the book to see what was written in it. What was written was none other than the lost text. Legboard continued to read the book. But then a gust of wind blew in from the window. Legboard dropped the book, which caused it to crumble into dust. Though Legboard was upset, a fair amount of knowledge was drawn from the book. Plus Frant. So, finally completed my quest. Kloth actually says something different when he returns from a quest. He says, "I finally complete my quest." Oh. Hey Kloth, have you learned any of the formations? I must have been cursed. You're the first person I saw today. I already know that you're cursed, but that's not the point. I'm asking you whether you learned anything yet. I know. Beat up the enemies that come after me and beat up those that run as well, right? I guess you haven't looked at the manual I gave you. Fighting is not a matter of theory, but of power. I'd appreciate it if you were not so picky about how I fight. You think power is enough to protect the country, to protect the queen? Your defeat may lead to the fall of this country. Keep this in mind. Mind your own business, I already know that. I would risk my life to protect Leoness. I won't say anything more. I just hope you will be able to protect her in any situation. I know. And that was just some plot dialogue stuff. Alright, so now if we look at our stuff. Red text means they are wounded. You cannot do anything with them for a month. If you get defeated in combat, like if your knight gets taken down through, you know, losing all their HP, that's the same as you'll be thrown back to wherever your you either get thrown back to your capital or you get thrown back to wherever your leader is at, and they'll be wounded for a month. All right, Isfoss and Kloth. Let's go ahead and send Kloth off to here. A lot of logistics stuff at the moment. And the only person I can send on a quest right now is Legoborg. My most useless knight. Alright, let's, how much rune power do you have? 200? Alright. Same deal, let's go ahead and get an angel. I'll give us 85. And then we'll have... Let's see, that's 85. Must be 140. I don't know. I'm right now at 85, so let's go... That'll be 120. 120... Not very many options here. I'll summon 2 centaurs. I really need to get some, probably some melee units. probably be a good idea. So I can actually, you know, have a front line to put my centaurs behind. So you have room for 45. We'll go ahead and summon a unicorn then. So yeah, I think I'll need to do a change of plans for Koloth. If you have like 4 monsters, that's probably a good spread to have at the very least. Oops. There we go. And we'll move you back to here. And change of plans for you, Koloth. Let's send you to, I think it's this place. No, this place is Griffin's. This place has wyverns. So many choices. Yeah, let's go ahead and just move you to Demos. It's fine. I'll just summon griffins. I just really need just something to take hits for while I hide behind them. So let's go ahead and execute this move. They're holding their own. Galawad's quest. Alright, so when Galawad was walking across the green field, a sweet aroma filled the air. Galawad walked towards the direction it was coming from and found a big kettle. It was filled with honey, although Galawad wanted to ask the owner for a treat. There was no one around. Galawad could not resist the temptation of the honey and sampled the taste. The honey was so sweet, Galawad's tired body began to heal. Moreover, energy arose from all over Galawad's body mysteriously. I cannot pronounce his name. All of a sudden, there was a buzzing sound. There stood a bee larger than a man. The kettle belonged to the bee. No one could survive being stung from this giant. Fortunately, the bee was not yet aware of Galawad. Galawad ran away. Thanks to the honey, Galawad gained 13 HP. Ryzen's quest. Ryzen discovered a figure on the wall of the ancient remains. Underneath it are the words, "Those wishing for a blessing receive it from my mouth." Indeed, there was a hole big enough for an arm to fit into at the mouth of the figure. Slowly, Ryzen's hand went into the hole. The hole was deep enough for Ryzen's arm to enter. Ryzen's arm was almost stretched fully, Ryzen's fingertips touched something. Ryzen pulled out the power potion. Awesome. Okay. So let's go ahead and organize items. Power potion increases strength by 3, which will increase her attack power. So let's go ahead and use that. There you go. You can actually use potions on monsters as well, with exception of the rune potions, and they will help you out. In some cases, you have to use them for just being able to actually cast spells with some of the monsters. Griffins are pretty cheap, and they're pretty decent. They're not as good as wyverns and rocks, but they do upgrade to holy griffs. And they do actually have an element to them, so that is a benefit. Okay. And we'll go ahead and summon ourselves another centaur. Yeah, like I said, I definitely like centaurs now, so I'm going to use them instead of djinns. And there we go. We got ourselves another set of three knights to defend and attack with. What are we looking at right now as far as domain's concerned? Yeah, as you can see, Norgard's in trouble. They're down to four cities. And they're kind of getting ripped into. Because all of his cities are now border cities, so he's spread thin. So I got, what, 9 monsters here? He only got 6 monsters here. This is his strongest unit. And yeah, he's spread thin across everything. So let's go ahead and execute this move. And see what we got. I don't really want to attack this city because that's going to put me in the center of everything. I really want to spread out this way first. Which I'm pretty sure he predicted. No, he didn't. So yeah, our next bit, we'll probably be attacking this guy. He only has 8 monsters. Most of them aren't pretty good. Except for this dragon. This dragon's pretty good. And he has some average level characters. What did he scout up here? Okay, he moved his lord all the way to the capital. The capital cities always provide more income than the regular cities. Usually about double. So yeah, not much to worry about here. As for down here, these guys have been left alone this entire time. I mean, I have a lot of monsters. I have a level 20 cardinal here, so it's a good deterrent. So what we'll do is we'll attack with Leoness. We'll try out this new archer we just got. And we'll attack the city. And I'll go ahead and save. And I'm going to go ahead and call this a video. I'm going to have to see how this splits up. And hopefully you guys will enjoy it. Because yeah, I'm going to probably play through a game of Brigandine. Just to show you guys a new strategy game. I'm still going to be doing Civ 5, of course. I'm pretty sure these will probably be going up together each day once I get done with the GRE. So, is this okay? Yes, save game. So yeah, we're closing on ending the first year. Not too bad. It's a little hard to expand from where you start out at, but once you get rolling, it won't be a big issue. I'm trying to think of how I'm going to do this. Attack here, attack there. Yeah, I'll have to like kind of zigzag, I guess. I might need another 3 knights. Oh well. Anyway. I'm the Depressed Eora, and this was Brigandine. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.